In this lecture, we will discuss about Stokes theorem. This theorem helps us to convert surface integral into line integral or line integral into surface integral. Mathematically, it is the surface integral of the curl of any vector field A taken over the surface S is equal to the line integral of the same vector field A taken over the boundary line C of that surface S. Suppose there is a vector field in some space and that vector field is moving on the right side. And suppose there is a three-dimensional open surface S that has the boundary line C. This three-dimensional structure could be any type of structure, like in our case, it is like inverted pot having the boundary line C. To prove this theorem, let's first work out the right-hand side of this equation. For this, divide the whole surface of this inverted pot into ith number of surfaces. And each surface segment has surface area ds along with the boundary line c. Like in the case of first segment, having the surface area ds1 along with the boundary line c1. And that boundary line you can see by these blue arrows. Please note, to specify the curl of any vector function at any segment, we need to decide the loop direction first. That could be either clockwise or anti-clockwise. But it's easy to, because draw the normal of the surface on upward direction, like you can see this n cap normal of the surface ds1. Hence, it's quite easy to take the curl of the line integral of the loop in anti-clockwise direction, which you can see by these blue arrows. The curl at any point is nothing but the line integral of that vector field per unit area. By using this definition, we can find how much is the line integral of vector field A on this surface ds1. And that can be written as del cross A is equal to line integral c1 A dot dr at segment ds1. So here we have per unit ds1. Which can further be written as surface integral del cross A dot ds1 is equal to line integral A dot dr. This is equation number one. This equation will be true for all elements. Hence, for the second element, we can write like surface integral S2 del cross A dot ds2 is equal to line integral C2 A dot dr. And for the ith element, that is surface integral SI del cross A dot ds I is equal to line integral on CI A dot dr. Now by summing up all equations, finally we get surface integral del cross A dot ds is equal to line integral A dot dr. Now the question is, are all elements contributing to the line integral of the Stokes theorem? To answer this question, let's zoom in the first two adjacent elements 1 and 2, where you can see in the element 1, the integral loop is anti-clockwise. And similarly, in the second segment 2, the loop integral is also anti-clockwise. At the common side between two adjacent elements, the line integrals are in opposite directions, and hence they cancel each other. It means that all the common sides among the elements are not contributing to the total line integral, but the contributions to the line integral are only due to the sides of the rim of this inverted pot, which is represented by C. And here you can see from the red arrows on this rim. Hence, the right side of this equation is made of the line integrals of only based on this rim C. Thank you so much for watching this video. That's all for the today's lecture. Please subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends.